Hi, I'm Marley Dias. Welcome to Bookmarks, celebrating Black voices. Rapper, actor, producer, and activist Common is going to read Let's Talk About Race. This book asks questions like, what's our story and what makes each of us special? Let's Talk About Race is written by Julius Lester and illustrated by Karen Barber. Let's listen to Common read Let's Talk About Race.
Hey, hey, peace y'all, this is Common. About to read you a story. I got a good story for you, okay? It's called Let's Talk About Race. I am a story. So are you. So is everyone. My story begins the same way yours does. Take me, for example. I was born March 13th, 1972. Kinda old, huh? How does your story begin? Many people and many events are part of my story, and yours too. And the names of our parents and where they were born, whether or not we had brothers or sisters. I had a brother who was 9 years older than me, but he is dead. God bless his soul. What kind of work our parents do or did? My father was a minister. My mother was a housewife. My story and yours have many elements, such as favorite food. Mine is fish. Hobbies. I like to do crossword puzzles, take photographs, and cook. Favorite color? Red. Or maybe green. But I like orange and purple too. I think my favorite color is all of them. Religion? Well, Julius's religion is Jewish. Nationality? I'm from the United States. Favorite time of day? Night. I love the night. Oh, and there's something else that is part of my story. It's part of yours too. That's what race we are. I'm Black. What race are you? Just as I am a story, and you are a story, and countries tell stories about themselves, race is a story too. Whether you're Black, like me, or Asian, Hispanic, or white, each race has a story about itself. And that story is almost always the same. My race is better than your race. Some stories are true, some are not. Those who say, my race is better than your race, are telling a story that is not true. Why would some people say their race is better than another? Because they feel bad about themselves? Yes. Because they are afraid? Mm-hmm. But there are other ways all of us, even me, even you, think we are better than others. I'm better than you because I live in a big house. I'm better than you because I go to this school. I'm better than you because I'm a boy. I'm better than you because I'm a girl. I'm better than you because my dad, mom, makes more money than your dad, mom. I'm better than you because I'm white. I'm better than you because I'm Black. I'm better than you because I'm Hispanic. I'm better than you because I'm Asian. None of these stories are true, are they? I want to tell you a true story, but I need your help. Here's what I want you to do. Take your fingers and press them softly against your skin right below your eyes. Like that. Easy. Be careful. Now, press gently, easy, until you feel the hard bone right beneath the surface. Press gently. Now, if your mom, dad, brother, sister, or friend is close by, ask them if you can touch them. If they say okay, take your fingers and press softly at the same place beneath their eyes. Easy, easy. Press until you feel the hard bones right beneath the skin. Now, press someplace else on your body, on your arm, your chest, your head. Press anywhere until you feel the hard bones beneath your skin. Now, beneath everyone's skin are the same hard bones. If you were to go outside without your skin on and without your hair on your head, turn the page and see what you would look like. Like that. But you want to know something? If I went outside without my skin, without my mustache and beard and the hair on my head, what I used to have on my head, I would look just like you. And you would look just like me. Suppose one day everyone in the whole world decided to take off all our clothes and all our skin and all our hair. Then we would do what we do normally every day. Go to school, go to work, play, shop. Everything would be normal, except we would look at each other and couldn't tell who was a man, who was a woman, who was white, black, Hispanic, or Asian. Which story shall we believe? The one that says, my race is better than yours? Or the one we just discovered for ourselves? Beneath our skin, I look like you, and you look like me. And she looks like her and him, and he looks like him and her, and he looks like him, and she looks like her, and they look like them, and they look like us. When I look at you, which story do I see? Do I see only the color of your skin, the shape of your eyes, the texture of your hair? Do I look at you and think, I know your story, when I don't even know your name? Or do I look at you and wonder, what's your name? When were you born? Where were you born? Where do you live? What do you like? What don't you like? Maybe we like and dislike some of the same things. Your race is not all that you are. My race is not all that I am. Yes, I am black, but I am also a man. I am of medium height. I have a deep voice and a loud laugh. I love to laugh. Do you? I live in a big house, in the woods, in a small town. I like pancakes and macaroni and cheese, and I am so many things besides my race. To know my story, you have to put together everything that I am. Like, I bet you didn't know. I'm a vegetarian. That means I don't eat meat. You didn't know that. Beneath the skin, we all look alike. You and me. I'll take off my skin. Will you take off yours? Let's Talk About Race by Julius Lester. Now, I told you all some things about me that you wouldn't know just by looking at me. So I would like for you to tell me something about you that I wouldn't know just by looking at you. Okay? God bless. Love.
It, adorn with it, a gift to the world, gon' give it. Fearlessly made, no need to be afraid. Angels are with you, the path is laid.
Don't forget who you are. 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 Don't forget. Don't forget who you are. Don't forget who you are.
Don't forget. Okay.
Yeah.